games, doesn't know how he's been
Oh
playing.
shit.
What's up?
I fucked up the overlay, dude, this whole time. They're gonna light us up for 90 seconds.
Oh, man.
Oh, mother of God. All right, let's do intros really, really quick. All right, our player in the bottom left-hand corner of the map, coming at it from Sonic Aftermath, it is Strife.
And...
No, I
and,
thought you were gonna do it too. Damn it, man.
And his opponent in the top right, it
oh,
is Pinecone.
All right, stand by for 90 seconds of getting fucking lit, Giggle Bear, because it's about to happen, dude. thank you for doing damage control. I do appreciate
you. No worries, man.
The good thing is, though, right, is that it was about the most mild 90 seconds that I've ever seen a ZBZ go down. I don't think even we've had first blood yet, so you guys lost absolutely nothing. So, yeah, yep. We didn't get a first blood at all, dude. So, okay, my bad.
Really? We haven't had a first blood at all? Like, it's
no, like, I haven't seen... Yeah, wait, let me check.
Units lost. Zero, yeah. Zero, zero, zero. Like, yep.
Okay. Well, that if that's my one fuck-up for the night, like, that's about the perfect timing that it could have gone. You can't blame the cat on me. Like, that was Sky's fault, dude. I didn't do shit. all right. So, Passion, by the way, is the person you want to talk to. That's the man we were just talking about, so... Ooh, the one differentiator I see coming down is that early plus one for Strife. That can really, really pay out in a ZBZ, so.
Yep.
Oh, to counter that, though, the Baneling Nest comes down for Pinecone, so.
Are these Lings from Pinecone going to be able to get in here and at least see these large number of Lings from Strife? And this probably is going to start triggering some alarms. You know, Pinecone's been a pretty aggressive player himself, so to see someone with more Lings than you this early in the game kind of lets you know, like...
Yeah, it definitely sets, like, the pace of the game and what you can kind of expect from here. Running into this wall, too, is going to be a bit discouraging. Oh, man, I really like that. He almost had it shored up, but the drone was a little bit off-centered. And because of that, these Lings might be able to poke in here. He actually is forced to pull a couple of drones and try to come around here and deal with this. Oh no! The drones get stopped and the queens are falling. Oh, he didn't want him to fight. He wanted them to plug the wall. Alright. I can get behind that decision, but the flood is just continuing behind this, dude. He needed some banes or really anything to swing the tide here.
Yep, Strife is doing a good job of, you know, running around constantly, taking good engagements with his Lings, and he's able to keep Pinecone now. These reinforcement Lings are just not going to be enough, man. He's going to have to back up, maybe look to get some Banes, and that's what he's doing here. Yep. Oh, man, Strife playing with fire as he's going for him. These Banes are about to pop. Do they get massive hits? Oh, it's a gigantic hit, man. Is exactly what Pinecone needed.
That was huge, man, and that's about as ZVZ as I thought it was going to go, man. That's kind of the definition there. A couple Banes, and you could be in a really bad position here. The interesting thing to me, though, is that it's still 24 workers to 24 workers, even though he lost 13. That's kind of a big deal, but there's no army to really deal with this just yet. That plus one, though, came into effect, though. That'll help out a lot here, but Pinecone is just relentless with this pressure. So...
Yep. So it looks like, oh man, all these drones going down in the main. And I think with that, that's going to force Pinecone's hand. He needs to find damage. He has absolutely... Does he have zero workers? He has zero workers, man.
Yep.
GG. After a fantastic Baneling hit.
Absolutely. That early Baneling, that's just sealed the deal there for Strife. And just like that, he will take game number one. I just wanted to address one really quick thing in chat. They asked, why is it a 90-second delay? Most streamers only have 10 to 30 seconds. Well... I'm not trying to be a dick or anything, but most organizations doing tournaments actually use a 3-minute timer. So we use less than most like organizations putting on a stream. But the reason we do it is because we used to pay the payouts out of our pocket, like way back in the day before we caught a sponsorship. So we didn't want to give our personal money to someone who was stream sniping. Like, but luckily we haven't had too big of an issue. But a minute and a half, even if you're stream sniping, you're gonna get, you know, like that. That information is almost useless at that point. So that's the reason. That's all.
It looks like Belshir is going to be next, man.
Yep, we'll get straight into it, man. What a crazy ass game number one, ZBZ. Am I right? All right. As soon as they're ready, we'll jump straight on into this. That was some monster play there. Getting down that early Banelingness was key.
Yeah, for sure, dude. That was Strife. Fantastic attack there, man. And Pinecone, too, doing a really good job, you know, trying to plug the hole with his drones, transfusing his queen. It was just too many Lings. Strife was taking really good engagements.
Interestingly enough, the last two bets we've had have been 50-50. This one's 50-52, so.
Huh.
That's crazy. Yeah, only four people bet 2-on-2 on each side, though. So everyone else just hoarding them doubloons, man. Saving up. All right, so let me throw up the scoreboard really quick. Okay, so our player in the bottom right-hand corner of the map, the blue Zerg from Psionic Aftermath, who's currently off 1 point in this best of five, it is Strife.
And his opponent in the top left. Then I have to find a way to get a win in this series if he wants to keep his tournament hopes alive. It is Pinecone.
Nice.
Oh, yeah, dude.
I fucked up the little intro there with my camera work. That was my bad. You had one job, Turk, earlier. I was trying to mess with the production and all that good shit. So, in his EDC, you gotta get all that rolling quick, you know?
Yeah, all I care about is the overlay good.
Oh shit, good point. And it is good. Blizzard is fraud. Avila was like 5 minute delay when he casts. I think the standard is 3 minutes. Like, I can't obviously speak for the bigger organizations, but like the three big boys or whatever you want to call them all use 3 minutes for what it's worth. And I know this from a fact because we copied all of their rules to make our rules. And that's the reason.
Yep. And I don't know, most of the people that play in this tournament, one, we obviously want to be, you know, communicative with chat and be interactive with you guys, but also everybody who plays is a lot of returning people. We do have some new people and we do vetting, but you know, all these people aren't going to stream snipe, man. They're mostly homies, so.
Yep. Punt to kill. Thank you very much for the follow, sir. We appreciate it.
Hype. That's what's up. That is what's up, man. We are getting so close to 600.
Yeah, that's pretty scary, dude. I think we should be able to hit it next week. We were going to do a $200 open tournament, actually, on the 25th, but I think we're going to have to push it back due to a scheduling conflict. But look for that here in the future. We got a couple of pros to come out last time and a lot of really good players, so this one should be pretty hype as well. We should be able to get that scheduled here in the immediate future. But you'll have to follow our Twitter to find out. No, I'm just fucking around. See what I did there?
Pay $5 to unlock downloadable content.
To talk in our channel, you have to follow us, man. Nah. Just kidding.
So, looks like pretty standard stuff here. Pinecone getting his natural saturated. I gotta say, though, man, the evolution chamber's down. The spawning pool is researching, just about halfway done with speed. We could see a similar build come out of Strife.
Yeah, I was kind of trying to figure out where he was going to head with it. He has that... Well, this time around, Strife goes for the early Evo, so maybe he's looking to get an upgrade and that early Baneling Nest. His Baneling Nest is the first one down, too, so it's starting to worry me a little bit. We'll have to see. You know, it's kind of early, too early to call shit, though. Oh, is Pinecone going for that signature Pinecone Southern base again?
I don't know, man. Yeah, he seems to like it. We'll have to ask him why he does that, man. Not like I have a problem with it. I'm actually, it's just a curious
trying
thing.
Trying to learn. Yeah, exactly. Like, if there's a reason for it, do tell, sir. Stripe's going to be able to poke up in here and find out that there's a Baneling Nest down. So he knows that that's coming. But still, this Ninja Third, maybe it's a good choice because it's not going to be scouted, dude. I guess I won't knock it until we see how this game plays out, so.
I mean, I feel the same way that I do about it the last time we saw Pinecone on Belshir, where it was like, well, if it doesn't get scouted, he's going to look like a genius. But if it does, he could be in trouble, you know?
Yeah. Kira's asking for Swag Syndrome. I think they said they were going to bed. If it's something I can help you with, hit me up.
Give me the deets.
Yeah, I'm trying to figure out why they need an admin. Maybe third, fourth place finished up or something. Let us know who won that, by the way. But...
So it looks like a huge move out of Banes and Lings, man.
Yeah, this is going to be a pretty significant attack, and I'm not sure the Pinecones are going to be able to hold on. It's all going to come down to these defensive Banes and whether or not they can find... Oh, connections! No!
Oh, that queen just back up and bait the... Okay, there we go. It's going to have to reposition here. Pinecone's going to be sending in... Oh, man, the one Bane that he needed. And this is just going to be a slaughter, man.
Yeah, absolutely. These Banes are going to come in and find the middle line pretty much undefended and get four drones for their troubles. Trying to circle around and following him. Okay, there we go. The second connect is devastating. Oh, the third was even worse. So far, 12 SCVs... Or 12 SCVs. Holy shit. 12 drones went down in all of those defending Lings. That was about as good as it could have went there for Pinecone. And not only that, but he's up a third base, and he has a pretty significant follow-up coming in. Jesus.
Yep. Yep. So that's kind of the icing on the cake there, as we were talking about, you know, if he could manage to keep the third base. Right now, I mean, he's on Strife's side of the map without any a care in the world about anybody scouting that third base, you know? So this is a very, as you said, ideal for Pinecone. Ooh, kind of took a bad Baneling there, though.
Oh my God, dude. That was about as close as I've ever seen a Baneling connect. That would have been huge. Yeah, so it turns out that was still pretty significant there, but I don't know if it's going to be enough for him to hold on here. Maybe. The follow-up's getting nasty.
The third is under siege from those Lings, man. They're starting to get to work on it, and Strife is too busy trying to deal with the stuff up in the main. He will eventually get a surround on that and clean those up. The plus one of his Lings is kicking in. It's definitely helping him in these small Ling engagements. Look at these two Banelings going up into the main here.
Yep. People are saying they would play, but they're only D3. So what, man? We've had G3s play every single week almost. So don't let that discourage you. You don't have to play only if you can win. Like, you might meet a practice partner. I know it sounds like we're only selling out when we say that, but I am serious when I say we've had a few people get better just from, like, meeting new people to bounce ideas off of. Like, it's lame when you put it that way, but it is true. And just like that, Pinecone will take it off the back of some insane aggression.
Yep.
It's funny because we were laughing about the third base, but it was the thing that ended up winning the game for him. Like, all right, joke's on us.
Definitely the nail in the coffin there. By the way, Outset Wolf, thank you for the follow on our journey to 600 followers, man.
Yeah.
We're getting so close.
Yeah, thank you guys. It's pretty hype the amount that we've gotten. So I remember we were just trying to figure out the giveaway for 500, and now we're already at 600. So that's awesome. Pretty badass. I'm glad we're tied up, though, and it's not going to be an absolute blowout or anything. So.
Yep, I totally agree, man. What is this? What are we playing? Newkirk? All right.
Yep. Zerg building SCV's game hat. Yeah, I know. It's so easy to do, though. When you're going for the worker word, sometimes you just blurt it out. So, my bad, guys. Shit happens.
Game three, man.
Passion says, go Strife, bring home the bacon for daddy. I like it. Nice. That's a good way to cheer on your clanmate, dude.
For sure. You got a job to do. You better bring it home or don't come back at all, man.
All right, we'll have to see what happens now that we are tied up. Let me make the scoreboard reflect that. Boom, I'm getting faster, guys. It only took me 4 hours to figure out how to update the scoreboard. So, our blue Zerg player in the bottom right-hand corner of the map, coming at us from Psionic Aftermath, it is Strife.
And his opponent in the bottom left, figuring out a way to get back in the series. When you get all in, what do? You just all in them back even harder, man. It is Pinecone.
Yeah, so for the record, Passion says he gets to keep the money. I've always wondered about that. Like, if you're on a team, do they take 20% of your earnings or something? Like, obviously not at the diamond level, but if you're on a pro team and you win money, does the team get a cut? Like,
I don't know.
I've always wondered about that.
It depends. I mean, it seems like on the surface, like, oh, well, the team's taking money from the player. But, like, what did the team do? Did they send the player to that particular event, you know? Like,
yeah, exactly.
I don't know what types,
like,
of
maybe
details.
Maybe they covered
of,
fair,
you know,
and shit.
Yeah, I don't know. I think it's different for every player in tournament.
Yeah, when we did the $50 clan wars, I wanted to ask each night we were handing out 50 bucks, like, whether or not the team was going to keep it or it was going to get dispersed through the five players, like 10 bones apiece, but I never asked. I forgot to each time.
Freaking,
I gotta know, though, man.
Just like, pizza party tonight, guys.
One
easiest
person
way
gets
to split
pizza.
This shit. Yeah, word. That's 50 bucks, man. That's a lot of pizza. What the fuck golden pizza are you eating?
Dude, I do eat golden flaked pizza, dude.
For sure, man. So, pool about halfway done for Strife and just about halfway done for Pinecone as well. So, similar builds coming out of both these players. You can see it in the production tab.
Yep, extremely mirrored. That's where I got the name. Nothing too crazy to talk about. That's why we're talking about gold pizzas and stupid shit. So, we'll take a little bit for this ball to start rolling. But if the last two games are any indication, you know, it'll get rolling hard here in just a second. So, be patient, guys.
I know, right? We will bring you the Baneling hits in just a bit.
Yeah, I'm waiting to see what's going to be the big differentiator, whether it's going to be that early Baneling nest or the early Evo. Usually there's something that kind of sets the two players apart, but so far it's extremely mirrored. Just a couple, two queens coming out and a couple Lings, so nothing too crazy just yet.
Yep, I really like Strife has been prioritizing the plus one melee early, and I really think that makes a huge difference in ZvZ.
Yeah.
Just took a couple of bad Bane hits, and Pinecone was the one who kind of dictated the aggression in that last game. But his plus one in those small Ling fights, I mean, really helped him. I mean, he was down, dude, but it helped him fight. And I think if he had just been a little bit more prepared for it, he probably could have, you know, shooed that away with relative ease, you know?
Yeah, I know it means absolutely nothing in the grand scheme of things, and I shouldn't put too much stock into it, but whenever we're casting a ZvZ, I always look for two things. Who gets the first Evo Chamber, and who gets the first Baneliness. Like, those are, like, the two really, really big things. Especially this early in the game, like, either one can kind of swing the battle your favor, so. Haven't seen either yet, though, so, you know, not yet.
So it looks like Pinecone going to be able to shoo those early Lings away from Strife. Pinecone going to go for a little bit of a wall here, or a semi-wall.
Yep. All right, so we have our first upgrade coming in, and it is Carapace. All right. Interesting. Just so you can take a couple more Bane hits and maybe not worry about it. I mean, I don't knock the decision at all, so it has its place for sure. Outset Wolf says, hey, guys, I'm looking for a new team. I'm a boosted Diamond Random. Anyone interested? Wait, are you memeing right now, or are you serious? What does boosted mean? Like, you got someone to put you in diamond or something? I don't know if you should use that as
hard to win those diamond games.
Yeah, I was like, I don't know if you should use that as an opener when looking for a clan, because they'll put you in like a diamond clan war, and then you'll get Shreked upon. So, no, but if you're serious, I would say hit up the CTL, ChoboTeamLeague.com. It's like 9 different teams, and then you can kind of shop around for your own clan instead of letting them come to you. That's my biggest suggestion.
So. We got a little something for everybody over there, man. A lot of different teams, and they're all pretty cool, too. We've dealt with a majority of them. I'm not sure that we've dealt with every single one from Chobo Team League, but we've dealt with a majority of them for sure, man.
I think everyone but Born Gosu. Have we fucked with Born Gosu yet?
No, I don't think so.
Yeah, I think they're the only... They're the elusive beast from CTL that we've not managed to work with yet. Not because of there's any drama or anything. Like, it's just, I think, straight scheduling conflicts. So, it happens. No big deal. But hopefully we can find you a clan, dude.
They only play StarCraft on Tuesdays.
Yeah.
No, we don't do anything on Tuesdays.
Like, the weekends are nothing. Pinecone coming in with a little bit of a Ling pressure, trying to get this third down. If he can get this, that'd be huge. That's even bigger.
Yep.
Yeah, I was hoping he wasn't going to get lit up for claiming boosting, but maybe it's just a meme that I'm not. Be good, though, guys. Like, it's all good. Oh, I mean, these Lings coming into this main, they might be able to find a couple drones. No Bane follow-up, though, so...
Third probably is going to be shut down for Pinecone as well. He does actually cancel it, though. And Strife will see the roaches, so that's really nice, too. He gets a decent scout off on that.
Yep, absolutely. That's a huge piece of information to have, because you definitely need to prepare for that. And he's, for the record, he says he's not boosted. He was just fucking around, but... No, dude, we should be able to find you a clan easy. If you want to join... The Nidus Discord, now I'm just selling out too much. There's usually like 13 or 14 clan reps hanging out in there. So I'm just selling out all over the place right now.
I know, right? Guys, go to Google Docket. No, I'm just kidding.
So what I need you to do is thenidus.com, click on clans. No. These roaches, though, I'm not sure if these Lings are going to be able to find enough damage. Maybe with plus one, but they don't have that. And you almost need that to fight roaches with Lings.
Yep. They won't be able to be cleaned up as easily, though. So we'll have to see. I know plus one melee attack is great for Ling fighting small amount of roaches, but let's see how plus one Carapace does. Reinforcing roaches, though, I think this may just be too much, but the main pack does go down for now.
Yeah, I don't know how to call it just yet. This third is going to fall either way, no question, but he might just push all the way through the game. The spine up here helps out a lot, but as I said, you need plus one melee to fight roaches with wings. Like, you almost need it. So the third will fall. Hopefully he can cancel it. Oh, he's going to try to defend it. Not with the roaches backed up into the corner like this. You can't get surface. Okay. No.
This is
don't do
an interesting engagement here for Strife to be taking, man. The third more than likely will fall. He knows that. He's already got that fourth going, too, so at least he can fall back to that.
Yeah, so they're asking, how do I play in the next one? So either I'll do it tomorrow. But check by the end of the day tomorrow on our profile where it says sign up. And that'll take you to the current challenge. We can just cut to the chase. It's going to be the Nidus / 18. So, spoiler alert. Like, that's what the URL will be. Yeah. But if you come click on that sign up button tomorrow, it'll shoot you straight over. It'd be cool to have you, though, man. Oh, shit. It's all fun and games are over, though, now that this +1/+1 is finished up on these links. They won't be able to take extremely favorable trades against these roaches, but they will be able to kill them now. But not that number. Holy shit, that's a lot of roaches.
Yeah, man, for sure. Strife is in an awkward spot here. He's, you know, has the third as far as up there. He doesn't have any drones on it. He's got a bunch of lings, man, but they're slowly starting to fall off as Pinecone gets more and more roaches.
Yep. Yeah, this is starting to be a scary, scary force from Pinecone, and we see him kind of just hit that point where he cuts drone production and just kind of, I don't know, builds nothing but units. Sometimes it's been like 174 to 90 and shit, so he definitely has the ability to kind of spiral out of control and supply, and I think Strife needs to be aware of that. So it's already starting to look a little grim, 122 to 87, so.
Indeed.
Indeed.
Indeed, indubitably. So this is a giant pack of lings, holy shit. But I mean, as we were talking about, it does kind of fall off to the giant pack of roaches, but it's rare that you see that big of a pack of lings, man.
So they're asking, so does Pinecone get to keep his cash this week? I know, right? For the record, he said that even if he wins, he's gonna just keep the donation to the Nidus. So I thought that was pretty cool. Like, not saying he's gonna win. It's only 1-1. I'm not ruling anyone out of this. I just, since you brought up the joke, I might as well put that out there. So,
it's fair, man. He is looking to be in a commanding position in this game.
Yeah, absolutely. But again, a huge shout out to the sponsorship that he provided, because it allows us to do huge things like the $200 open, the $150 open, the multiple $50 clan wars we just did. So his sponsorship actually helped us do a lot of stuff as a channel. So I know we keep touching on it, but it's kind of a big deal. So
yeah, for sure, man.
And while we got a little bit of this stale pause, we might as well talk about it anyway. But this is starting to be pretty significant, though. I like the fact that Strife really, really caught up in supply. There for a while, he was down 50 supply, and now it's only 6 difference. So very, very well played from Strife. The fact that he has that fourth up and running is just kind of, you know, playing in his favor pretty significantly here. I don't think... Does Pinecone... Yeah, Pinecone has no idea about the fourth. Oh, the horror.
Yeah, man, this could be a pretty interesting engagement here, because that fourth is going to be there for Larva. The third's got a bit of saturation on it as well. Strife is really probably just waiting for Roach Speed to finish up here. Pinecone's just about to finish 2-2 upgrades, though, so I imagine we're going to see him move out right after those finish.
Yep, it's timed up too good to be a coincidence. That is for a push, and as we say that, he's marching, so we'll have to see how it goes. Strife is caught up in supply, though. There's only a 1 supply difference, so we can just cut to, you know, round that out and say they're tied in supply. It's really all going to come down to this engagement, but I think the huge thing that's going to factor into play here is the fact that Pinecone has +2 range. That's huge, and when you're tied up in supply, that could be the differentiator. But we're off to it, man. We'll have to see how this plays out. Getting a good wraparound here, though, is Strife.
Oh my goodness. Fantastic concave out of Pinecone, dude. Well played.
Yep. I don't know. I mean, I don't want to be a broken record, but +2/+2 against, you know, nothing is pretty significant there. So, and a dead even supply fight, and with a good concave, you're going to find an advantage there. So,
yep. Absolutely, man. So, what was that? New Kirk, it's going to be on our grounds.
All right. All right, so Pinecone is currently up 2-1 in this best of 5.
Man, Strife came out looking really good in that first game. Super aggressive, man. And then Pinecone is just kind of, you know, taking the driver's seat of the series as he's forced, you know, a game really aggressively, and then forced a game into the mid game, late game, you know. Yeah. So if I was Strife, man, I'm not 100% sure what I'd be thinking right now. Like, do I go aggressive where I had success? You know, do I play defensive and try and out macro him?
Yeah, absolutely, man. You could tell there was a bit of a hesitation there, but he hung in there for sure. As I was saying, he was down like 50 supply, and he somehow brought it back from there. So that's more than I could have done, you know. So
yep.
Very well played for sure. But Pinecone just had the extreme upgrade advantage. Well, extreme, but you know what I mean. 2-0s. Quite,
yeah,
nice.
Yeah, huge, dude. Yeah. That's massive in a mirror matchup, man.
Yeah, with tied supply, I mean, that's a pretty big deal. So
yeah,
we'll have to see how it plays out on Honor Grounds.
It's a fucking big deal, Zarglar.
Yeah. No, you stick with what you said. That's a huge deal. What do you think about this map, Giggle?
I like it. It's crazy, man. It can get really weird, and I feel like a lot of it is just, you know, you feel like you're running through the fog of war, but...
Yeah. All right, so our orange sponsor in the top right-hand corner of the map coming at us from Clanless. I didn't see that he dropped MG. Oh, well. It is Pinecone.
And his opponent in the bottom left of Honor Grounds, the Blue Zerg, needs to find a way to come back in this series. From Psionic Aftermath, it is Strife.
Yeah, and it should go without saying, but I'm going to say it anyway, because this is a best of five. If he wins, that's game. So the scoreboard was fucked up. It is a best of five, not a best of three. So just throwing that out there. No one kill me or anything.
Oh, shit, man. We see a gas already down for Strife. Is he going to build a hatch? So gas, hatch, pool.
Okay. And we have a hatch, gas, pool. So just a little early gas there. Nothing too crazy. Kaye says, I kind of miss the Nidus commercials. Pause the game and tell them 30-second TV timeout. Damn. I'll take that as a compliment, I guess, dude. I like that. Thank you, man. People actually want to watch our commercials. Too bad we don't make any money off of them. Like, yeah.
So I wonder what this is going to be for here, because this gas was taken much before, you know, the hatchery was.
Yeah.
And what do we see? An evolution chamber. Okay, man. So this is probably going to be for Ling Bane plus one, I imagine, melee. And
the Carter
this has,
build straight
this
up.
This is, yeah, yeah, a build that has potential to even up the series. These overlords will eventually scout both the bases, and he'll be able to tell where Pinecone is.
Yep. Bold prediction, Kaye, but I think it's safe to say it's going to be 3-2 Zerg wins. Oh, shit. The dank memes. We'll have to see if Strife can pull one out. I mean, I think it's starting to look like it. If I had to call it right now, I'd say he has it. But it's a ZVZ, dude. One fucking Bane and, like, the entire game changes. So that's why I normally don't call ZVZs until a score screen, because it's just too crazy, man. Oh, my God. Another fucking 90 seconds. Oh, God, guys. All right. So our Blue Zerg player in the bottom left-hand corner of the map, it is Strife. My bad, guys.
And his opponent in the top right, it is Pinecone. Do you have it on the second screen?
Yeah, that's the funny part, dude. I've just been ingrained in this ZVZ, dude. My bad, guys. Fuck. I even have it hotkeyed this time around, too, so my bad.
Fucking blew it. All right, so Baneling Nest coming down for Pinecone. Do we see Baneling Nest?
Did we even get a first blood yet, though, or is it the same thing as last time around?
I mean, it's Honor Grounds, dude. They haven't even found each other.
Yeah, that's true. So you guys didn't miss anything except for a little bit of annoyance. And you got to stare at Giggle Bear's pretty face for a little bit longer. So, I mean, hey, is it really a loss in the end? So
it's pretty funny.
Oh, well, at least we know no one was stream cheating. That's a good point. Nah, I'm fucking around, dude. These guys are honorable gentlemen. But yeah, as you said, that plus one melee is coming into effect extremely early, and he doesn't have his Baneling Nest. I was really waiting to see that Baneling Nest come down too, and then it would be the straight up Carter build. So, yeah. I think he'll be able to hold on here just because of plus one melee, though, right?
Yeah, I'm not 100% sure. By the way, I don't actually know what does the score say in the game.
Pinecone 2-1.
Okay, word. That's right.
Yeah, somebody, isn't that correct?
There's all sorts of... No, the chat was all sorts of crazy with 3-0s and shit, and I was like, no, it's fucking...
Oh, those Strife were just all out. Their predictions and shit. Yeah,
I got you.
Yeah.
Strife won the first game. Like, what the fuck, guys? Yeah, come on!
Come on, how can you 3-0 one game? Mm-hmm. No. Oh, man, but as we were saying, that plus one kicking in right at the perfect time, and now he's going to be able to definitely defend this. The one thing that Pinecone has going for him, though, is the safety banes, man. That's going to be able to shut down any immense Ling Flood or anything. If he can find some good connects, that might actually... Oh, my God.
Oh, God. Yeah.
Okay, so that could have been a lot worse. Yeah.
We'll have to see, though, man. Those Lings could shut off most of those. Okay, so they do... Body black for most of those Lings there. Oh, Jesus Christ, man. This is getting pretty intense, dude.
Yeah. This is about as ZVZ as it gets right here. Strife just continuing to flood in here with that plus one melee, which will definitely turn the tide here. I think this third will fall regardless, just given the amount of flood coming in. But I'm okay with that, dude. A tied game. Tied game's where it's at. It's a little too early to call it, though. As you said, a couple Banes, you know, could definitely change this game. We'll have to see, though.
I'm just, like, watching this. Like, I'm just... I don't know what... I can't call this. There's Lings fighting each other.
Wait,
it's nuts,
fuck,
man.
Is the stream live for you? My preview's showing down right now.
Yeah, it's not too.
Oh, okay. Weird. My fucking preview locked up. I just got all nervous, so my bad, guys. This Link fight, though, is really going to have to rely on these safety banes that he has.
Yep, absolutely, man. This is starting to get pretty crazy here. I was just like, Jesus. Orange and blue, at least, are yeah. Totally different colors. Pinecone is able to clean this up for now.
Yep.
Strife continuing to, you know, send Lings across the map. Both players on three bases here. So, no stabilizing in sight, but they are on three base, which is nice.
Oh, okay. They're just talking about delay. 2 minutes, really? Yeah, I thought it was 30-second delay. No, we run 90 seconds, actually, so... Sorry, but you guys scared me. I thought this stream dropped. I started shitting myself. Jesus.
Thames315, thank you very much for the follow, man. We're getting so close to 600, but...
Yeah, Psionic Aftermath threw us a host, so thank you guys very much for that. I'm assuming where that follow came from. We are in a straight-up ZBZ war. If Pinecone wins this, he wins the tournament and $10, so it's kind of all on the line right now. We'll have to see if he can hang on. Strife has that upgrade advantage, but because he lacks the Banes... It's going to be a little rough for him. He is going with that early Roach, though. That might help out. So, we'll have to see. They're asking why we run a delay. Only because there's a payout, so we think it's fair. Oh, man. Pinecone trying to come in with this Bane. There's one hero Bane left. Oh, shit. That was a pretty good connect there, so...
For sure, man. Strife doing a good job finding some damage here. The plus one melee, I mean, it cannot be overstated how helpful that is in these small Ling battles.
Yep. And we also got a huge update on third place. Swag Syndrome says, with Shook Nasty winning map number one, Kira rallied back to take map two and map three. Congratulations, Kira, to third place. Hype.
Man. Nice.
Yep.
Awesome.
Thank you very both. thank you both for participating. That one fucked me up.
Yeah, for sure, man. All right, Tonight's Immortal brought to you by...
So Pinecone trying to poke in here and find a little bit of damage into that third, but Strife is pretty well defended, and he still has the upgrade advantage. So as we were saying, it's going to be really hard for Pinecone to poke in here. The thing I like going for Pinecone, though, is that he has the Spire down already. So it's going to be Roaches versus Mutas. We'll have to see how that plays out, so...
Roaches versus Muta. We all know how that plays out, but the question is... do the Mutas get up in significant numbers before the Roaches are able to push across the map, man? Yeah.
Well, that's kind of how it all comes down. If you can poke across and get enough drones down, the Mutas don't really matter. So it is kind of all about timing. This is gearing up to be a pretty significant push, though, from Mr. Pinecone. I mean, the Banes alone are nasty, and then look at the Link Flood behind this. It's 104 to 90, though, so I don't know, man. We'll have to see. It's all going to depend on how these Banes find damage. Oh, shit, it's looking pretty grim, though. Oh! The Banes.
Oh, man. So I have to see here, man. Those Banes do get in here. Gonna smash down on some drones. They're actually a queen. Pick up the queen. The Roaches do a good job of shooing this away for now. Four drones going down and a queen. Really, the second, this is all just kind of a delay waiting for the Mutas to come in.
Yep. So the Spire is finished, by the way. He just invested into six Mutas. So I'm not sure if that's like a game-changing number, but considering there's no spores in any mineral line, that could cause a lot of damage. Coupled with the fact that a Ling run by just picked off the Queen in the main and the Queen in the natural as well. So yeah, this is looking pretty strong here from Pinecone, man. What a beast.
Yep.
Oh, the
I
Roaches,
agree.
Though. Should be able to hold out.
Continuing to be annoying with these Lings, though. I mean, look at him. He's got some over in the main area, dude. He's really starting to get to work on those, too, as most of those drones are getting low. 5, 6, 7 now going down, and more coming into the third. These Roaches are good, but and they have decent numbers, but unfortunately, they're being so spread out now. Nice hold position there from Pinecone. Finally, Strife is able to get all of his Roaches together and maybe push across the map here.
I feel so bad for him because after he just cleaned up all that bullshit, now he's got to deal with four Mutas coming in across the map. Like, but you know, but oh, wait, wow, it's way more than four.
Eight.
Holy
so,
shit,
no,
they're multiplying. No, that was a bad call. I was just checking production, so my bad. But yeah, I feel a little bit unfortunate for him because now he has to deal with this Muta flock. I do really like this, though. Choosing to attack means that the Mutas have to come back and defend home. But Pinecone's going to counter that by doing a huge Ling run by. Jesus, man. This is a pretty epic ZBZ, dude.
Absolutely, man. Pinecone seems to be everywhere as Muta's coming back to take out the Roaches. That is a big ball, but eventually they will take them down, man, for sure. That's a lot of spores coming out of Strife. He's doing whatever he can. His tournament life is on the line, but it's looking like Pinecone may be able to take this.
It's all fun and games till 4 mutas pop out and then turn into 20, dude, because the caster can't count. yeah, so I do think this was the correct decision from Strife, trying to poke in here and get a little bit of damage done. Holy shit, I didn't see the amount of spines coming down from Pinecone. It's almost comical, the amount of spines that are about to pop here. Somehow I completely missed that because I was too invested in the Roach March.
Yeah, I know, right? That's a whole lot of spines, man.
Yeah, so Strife's just going to push straight on through it and try to find some damage up in the natural, but GG will be called, and Pinecone will take the Nidus number 17. Congratulations to Pinecone.